Now, the same thing happens every night. We have 5 children. They sit in the center. My wife is at this end, I'm at this end. And our children enjoy their dinner because my wife allows them to listen to their music. So you get to... And the children eat and they... I don't look at them. I just keep... Now, my wife looks the situation over, and she can tell when the children are not going to eat anymore. See, she can tell. They've fooled around long enough. All right, now, you fooled around long enough. Everybody get up from the table. My wife says this every night. Everybody get up from the table, go upstairs, take off all your clothes, get into the shower. Please turn on the water. You have to tell them to do that. Because if you don't, they'll just wander around the tub. And then get out and get in the bed. Please use soap. That's mostly for my son. Rinse yourselves off. Dry yourselves off, put on clean pajamas, get into the bed, and go to sleep. Now, if these brain-damaged children would do that, there would be no beatings. But there's going to be a beating tonight. And the children get up to go upstairs, and I kiss them goodnight, and I try to warn them. Please, do what your mother says, or somebody's going to get it tonight. And the children kiss me, and they pat me on my head, and they smile and look at me as if to say, dear man, thank you for your kindness and your wonderful attitude about this whole situation, but you don't understand. We cannot sleep through the night unless we've had a good beating. And so they go upstairs, and I can tell they're going to get it because they've started already before they even get upstairs. Will you stop touching me? And you're touching me, you stop touching, you're touching me, you're touching me. Mine, mine, mine. Now they get upstairs, and all you hear is... Now my wife talks to the ceiling. All right up there. I know you don't want me to come up there. I don't hear any water running. Now downstairs comes our 7-year-old. The informer. This is the same child that my wife sends with me whenever I'm going out somewhere. The informer's favorite words are, guess what? I'm a mom. Innis is upstairs, and so I'm going to get into the shower, and so then he took the towel and popped me on my behind. Go upstairs and tell Innis I said not to do that anymore. But my mom already told him, so then he took the towel, so and guess what? Innis popped me in on the behind with the towel, so I said, Innis, I'm going to tell Mom or you. Go upstairs and tell him I said not to do it again and take your clothes off. Okay, but I know he's just going to pop me in the behind again, because he's always popping people. 4 minutes later, downstairs comes the 4-year-old. She is naked and wet. Shampoo in her hair has run into her eye. She's running in place and yelling. Walking with her, also naked and wet, with a smile on her face, is the informer. See, Mom, I told you. And it took him pour water on the baby and the shampoo run into her eye, and she may be blinded for life. Now my son, who is 11 years old, comes downstairs. He has on his pajamas. They are stuck to his body because he forgot to dry himself. Mom, I'm trying to take a shower upstairs, and so then they come in the shower. I told them I'm too grown for them to be showering with me. I don't want them. The baby turns and kicks him. The 7-year-old punches him. He punches the baby. Shoves the 7-year-old. They're fighting. My wife turns around, grabs a yardstick. She holds it like a samurai warrior. She then makes an announcement that the beatings will now begin by saying, I have had enough of this. Now, these three brain-damaged people have the nerve to look surprised. My wife says, shh. Children run everywhere. Now, my job is I am the goalie. The children come at me, I kick them back into play. Now, the beatings are over, not because I see my wife, but because I hear all of upstairs going, Now, here's the funny part. My wife comes downstairs with the broken stick, throws it on the table, sits down, and begins to talk out loud to nobody. Gonna tell me that you are not going to do something when I tell you to do something. I mean, you move when I say move. Think I carried you in my body for 9 months so you can roll your eyes at me. I'll roll that little head of yours down on the floor. You don't know who you're fooling with. I'll beat you until you can't grow anymore.